Welcome back, guys. This is where I had left off. Guys, I have already shared all these PPTs with you people. So you can definitely go online on Reference Globe website and you can view these PPTs. I have also shared it on WhatsApp. So please refer to the PPTs once you are done watching the videos. Okay. So basically we have under vector class, there are about four constructors that we have to talk about. The first constructor does not have any parameters or arguments. The second one has one parameter, the third one has two parameters, and fourth one has one parameter. So we'll see, we'll go through one by one. The first one does not have any parameters. So when a vector constructor does not have any parameter, it means that it creates a dynamic array of size 10. So initially the capacity of that particular array is going to be 10. Okay, so I can put 10 elements, the capacity will be 10 initially. And then if I want to add the 11th element, then the capacity will increase two times the current capacity, that is 2 times 10. So it will add 10 more index values. That means it will become, total capacity will become 20. So this is how it keeps on increasing. So next after adding 20 elements, if I want to add the 21st element, then it will do 2 times the current capacity, that is 2 times 20. So the next time the capacity will become 40. So it basically doubles. So that is how it keeps on increasing dynamically whenever you create an object for a vector class without any arguments or parameters. As you can see here, it creates an empty vector object with an initial capacity of 10. And if the elements exceed the initial capacity, then the new vector is equal to current capacity times 2. Now, this is a very, very important point. So make sure you remember the size and make sure that it increases in this way. That is, it increases by multiplying 2 times the current capacity. Now, this is a very important interview question, as well as it may be coming in your exams. Second, the second vector constructor has only one particular argument or parameter. That parameter is your initial capacity. So basically your initial capacity by default is 10. But if I want to have any other initial capacity other than 10, then I can specify in my vector constructor here, right? So basically I can give 5, I can give 8, I can give 15, I can give 20, whatever initial capacity I want to give. But the incremental capacity, incremental capacity is going to be the same. That means if the initial capacity is 20 and I add a 21st element, it will do 2 times the current capacity for this second constructor also. So that means it will be, the size will be, new size will be 40, right? So, but the initial capacity can be either increased or decreased based on your requirement. Third one, we have two arguments. Or two parameters, that is initial capacity as well as incremental capacity. Now the initial capacity you have already seen from the second one, that you can increase the initial capacity or decrease it based on your requirement. And the second one is a new one for you, that is incremental capacity. By default, the incremental capacity is 2 times the current capacity. But when I talk about the incremental capacity, basically what it does is, if the initial capacity is 10, and I give my incremental capacity as 2, and after adding 10 elements, I want to add the 11th element, then the capacity will actually become 12, because the incremental capacity is 2 that I have given. So it will increase by 2 every time. So after 12 elements, if I want to add one more element, 13th, then the capacity will increase to 14, and so on. So that is how the incremental capacity works. So the initial capacity is what you have specified, and the incremental capacity is what you can specify also. Finally, the fourth one is a collection object that you can pass. So any of the collection objects can be interchanged, or it will be converted to an equivalent vector array. So these are four constructors that you have to know under the vector class. They are all very, very important. So please go through them thoroughly and read and try to. And once done with this, I will be going through the program. So this is a short video. I will come back for the next slide in the next video. Thank you.